into square sizes like this. And then I normally keep it in the fridge so that it becomes a little hard and I can cut really clean pieces of the potatoes. Deep fry it in some oil. I have already heated a pan along with some vegetable oil and I'm going to deep fry the peanuts, potatoes and bread. But before that, I'm going to add just a pinch of salt into the potatoes. Just 2 pinches of salt. And that's it. I'm going to mix it well and then I'm going to deep fry potatoes, as I said, the bread pieces and the peanuts. I have heated here some vegetable oil. To this I am adding the potatoes. And I am going to deep fry it till it becomes nice golden and brown. Potatoes have become a little golden in color. You can see this is nice golden and brown. So this is ready. I am going to take it out. I am using the leftover oil from the fried potatoes to fry the bread pieces. Ensure that the oil is nice and hot, becomes nice golden and brown. If you want, you can toast it up in an oven if you don't want to deep fry it. Do ensure that the oil is nice and hot, as I said, because otherwise the bread pieces will soak up a lot of oil. Anyways, the bread will soak up a lot of oil, so what I'm going to do is to put the fried bread pieces on a paper towel so that the extra oil is gone. And it takes literally seconds for the breads to get browned up and become golden and brown. You can see nice golden color of the bread, so it has already turned a little golden. If you want to trim the edges of the breads, you can do it. So this is ready. The bread pieces are nice golden and brown in color. I'm going to take it out. And I'm using the leftover oil from the fried bread pieces to deep fry the peanuts. Eat, otherwise it won't be crunchy. So in goes the peanuts. And fry it on low heat till it becomes nice golden in color. So this is ready. I'm going to take it out. So the frying part is done. The next thing is of the bread, the fried bread slices. And on top of that, I'm adding the potatoes or the fried potatoes, then the peanuts. After deep frying the peanuts, I took out the skin. Now goes the yogurt. I have added about 4 to 5 tablespoons of yogurt. This is up to your taste. And now some finely chopped onions. Again, up to your taste. I have taken about 4 tablespoons of onions. Now goes some green chutney or coriander onion chutney. I'm adding about 2 tablespoons of green chutney or hari chutney. Now 2 tablespoons of red chutney or meaty chutney or tamarind chutney. Again, it depends on your taste. If you want a little sweeter, then you can always add more. And now I'm adding some save, fried save. Again, up to your taste, more or less. Finally, I'm adding a little bit of red chili powder. I'm adding here some cayenne pepper because I don't want it very spicy, but again, it depends on your taste. If you want it a little spicy, then you can add the Indian red chili powder, chaat masala on top, about a teaspoon of chaat masala. And finally, I'm adding some roughly chopped coriander on top, and that's it. This is ready. This is a very quick and very easy chaat recipe. You get the crunch from the peanuts and the bread slices, and then you have the crispy fried potato pieces and all kinds of chutneys. So this is a very, very delicious recipe. Do try this very easy and quick bread chaat, and don't forget to let me know about it. We will meet next time, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Till then, bye-bye.